Hello everyone, this is Melanie from Melanie B's Creative Studio. And today we're gonna talk about dry mounting. I've brought to you dry mounting in the past, but that was the dry mounting where you go to Michael's or an office supply store and you can have them put it into a machine and it will flatten your canvas and seal it to a foam board. Well, we're in the middle of a pandemic and I figured we need to discuss how you dry mount a canvas on your own. So that's what we're gonna do in this video. Now, I have brought to you dry mounting, tape mounting, stretching on a canvas, a stretching on a DIY frame. And so today, this is an actual dry mounting technique where we're gonna use dry adhesive on a foam board and we're gonna make it work for us. Now, when you go to the store to buy foam board, it's gonna be larger than the piece you're going to need for your canvases. This one, thankfully, was already cut down to size because I did it when I was back at my frame shop at Michael's. And I just used the wall cutter, which is like whoosh, whoosh, done, you know, kind of thing. So I'd already measured this piece. I'm using a board that actually had a dry mounted canvas on it originally, but I had taken that off. So this is what I'm gonna be using. So I'm basically just recycling this board. Now, another reason I wanted to bring you this video is that some of the Michael's framers, I don't know if they're just not trained properly or if they're just really intimidated by the dry mount machine. And I'm not gonna say anything negative because I know that when I first started at Michael's, I was super intimidated by the dry mount machine. The first thing you learn is this machine can destroy every single thing, you know? So you're sitting there and you're terrified. So I tested it with canvas. That is how I know it works with canvas. A lot of you guys are going to Michael's and they're telling you they cannot dry mount a canvas. That is not true. They can't dry mount a canvas that has been painted. You don't ever want to put any kind of paint into a high heat situation. And when I dry mounted canvas, it was like, I think it was 210 degrees is what I had the machine set on. And it's been, y'all, it's been 10 months. I haven't done it since then. I can't remember. But the setting that I used was anywhere from 190 degrees up to about 210. So I don't want to put painted surfaces in that. No, absolutely not. But a blank canvas that has never been touched, it is fine to dry mount. It is not permanent. Now, when I first did my very first dry mount video for you guys, I did think it was permanent until one day I tried to pull it off and it just peeled right off. And I was like, oh, that's even better. So not only does the dry mount machine get out wrinkles, but it will put it on that temporary background. If you want it to be permanent, you can just put that thing in a frame like it is. But if you need to peel it off and stretch it, you can do that too. So you have more options that way. The bottom line is not everybody in those framing departments are trained, I guess, on the dry mount machine. So the fact that they're telling you no, they can't do it might be a good thing for you. Maybe they just don't want to take the responsibility of messing up your canvas. So that might be why. I didn't get intimidated that easily, I guess, and it was my money and my canvas, so that's when I tried it, and I was like, oh, this works perfectly. Otherwise, I would never have brought it to you guys. If I thought for a minute it was unsafe to put your canvas or if it was going to affect it in any way, you know, I just took a canvas that I had paid for, and I was like, this is just going to be my trial run, you know, and I did it. I got it off Amazon or something. I was like, well, let me just try it, and it was a folded piece, and you'd never know it was a folded piece. So, having said all of that, those are my disclaimers. This will keep you from having to go make a trip to Michael's. If everybody goes back in lockdown, this is your alternative. Now, there's also another alternative of spray adhesive. I don't mess with spray adhesives. I don't like the fumes. I get migraines. I don't want to have to take it outside. It might be raining on the day I want to spray mount. You know, it's just, it gets everywhere. Everything is sticky. So I thought, what am I going to do? I'm going to revert back to my scrapbooking days and my paper crafting days. What would I have done then? So I would have done something like this. It says permanent and transparent. So here's my thinking on this. This is the first time I'm using this for this purpose. And this is something I can use for a million other projects. So I was totally okay going ahead and investing in this. And so that is something that, you know, you might want to do also. But I already had a piece of foam board. You know, I wanted to try this, and I can use this with my die cut machine. I can use this with all these other things. So this is what we're going to do. So a couple of things you need to keep in mind when you're buying your adhesive. The reason I chose this one is for several reasons. I did research, you guys. I looked it up and I found a double-sided adhesive, acid-free, and permanent. So when I say permanent, this may not be permanent because it's canvas and that's a fabric. Fabric with any kind of adhesive may or may not stick as well. We're gonna try it. If it doesn't stick, this video will be thrown in the trash, poo-poo. So I'm going to use my Kate's Moon painting that I did a video on back, I think it was in June. Since I've decided to start going back to paintings from each company, this is the one I thought I would try just for, you know, to test it for quality and then bring back to you an update on it. Now it does have some folds in it, so I'm hoping that I can remove that as I mount this. You'll notice I had a label. This is from a Fomemo M110 label maker. This is how I label all my canvases, and I just put this at the edge and wrap it. This has all the information, how much I paid, when I bought it. So I have the information on the canvas about this piece. I have done a Fomemo video that I still haven't uploaded yet. I did it months ago when I first was changing out my studio, and it's a fabulous little tool. All right, let's get this unrolled. So to cut down your board, you're going to put down a cutting mat. You're going to use a utility knife and a T-square or a long measuring tape marked, and you're going to cut down your foam board to the size that you need to match the overall size of this piece. All right, so I have the canvas kind of ready to go. So I'm taking this 12 by 12 piece of paper, and I'm going to cut it into strips. And that's how I'm gonna lay it down so that the outside has strips all around it. And then I'm gonna put one solid piece right in the middle. That way 90% of this board has adhesive on it. So let me do that right quick. So you guys, I'm using a trimmer to cut these down. You can use scissors. They don't have to be pretty. They don't have to be exact. They just need to, you know, be able to be placed down to cover the surface. So what I'm using are 2.5 sheets of the adhesive paper. I will trim down this part that is overhanging before I peel the backing off. So let's go ahead and we're gonna do that. I'm gonna work around the entire thing, peeling off the backing and putting it on the foam board. I'm not going to make you watch that in real time. I will time-lapse that part. All right, so now that I have put all the double-sided adhesive down, I'm gonna need to pull off the backing paper before I place my canvas. So this is gonna be tricky. Now, normally tweezers are a wonderful tool to have in this situation. Okay, so when I peel this backing paper off, it leaves the adhesive on the foam board. So it's super sticky, you guys. So we're at the point now where all the adhesive is exposed. Let's try this canvas. Now I'm gonna start very carefully by placing one corner, because if it doesn't wanna lift up, I wanna make sure I got it straight. and then I'm gonna smooth it down. Okay, so then I'm gonna push my hand under it and smooth as I go. Let me get my brayer. Okay, so I'm gonna use my hands and then I'm gonna go back over it with the brayer. I feel like it's probably a little easier to do it this way. That way I'm not missing anything because I can feel the adhesion. All right, so this does not have to be lined up edge to edge to be a perfect, you know, if I've got a little bit of overhang, if this canvas wasn't cut straight, it's fine. Because what would happen is when I'm done with this piece, I can take it and trim it down to a 16 by 20, even if it means I have a little bit of border, and a 16 by 20 is gonna go into a frame. You guys would not have to stretch if you didn't want to. You don't put glass on acrylic paint unless you have spacers that will give you space between the glass and the painting. You don't want over time your paint to, if it ever got into a place where it was hot, you're storing it, it would stick to the glass and it is ruined. So that's the purpose of keeping the space between the painted surface and the frame and the glass. All right, that's it, you guys. That is a dry mounted piece. Now, this had some ripples and wrinkles and stuff in it, but those seem to have been eliminated. For time purposes, I did not put adhesive in every little square inch. You could definitely do that. This will save you money and time. I think it's gonna be a super way to DIY dry mount your canvases. All right. Thank you guys, as always, for watching and for being here and for your continued support. You guys know how much you mean to me. I want to see you back. So don't forget to hit that little subscribe button in that corner over there. If you're in the large screen, if you are expanding your screen on your phone, you'll see this little button in the corner and just click it and it's going to let you subscribe to my channel. And I appreciate it. Don't forget to join me on Patreon. I also have a Patreon exclusive Facebook group. So what that means is one of the perks you get for your membership is that you get access to the Facebook group for Patreon members. I've had a couple of people send me a request to join. I think they did that accidentally because both my groups look very similar. And I've had to deny them, which makes me like hurt. But it is only for Patreon members as just one of the perks for their membership. And that is all for today, you guys. Hope this has been helpful. Hope this saves you money. So, hey, I hope it saves you aggravation of somebody telling you they don't dry mount canvases, because that frustrates me. But that's it. And I will see you guys back soon. You know I will. I've always got something up my sleeve. All right. Thanks as always for watching. Have a wonderful day.